Welcome back students to your science class. Here I am your Dipanita ma'am. Today we will start the revision of the next chapter, Animals World. As we have completed the chapter, the plants around us. By this time I think you have completed the revision work at your home. Yes, so student, we will start the chapter Animal World. I will read out for you and you will listen now. You will listen carefully and please pay your attention. Chapter Animal World. There are different types of animals. Some animals live in forest while some animals are kept at homes and farms. So some animals lived in forest while some animals are kept in home or farms. The topic is the pet and domestic animals. Some animals like dog and cat live with us in our home. These are pet animals. We must look after the pet animals. Some animals like horse, cow and duck live near our house or in the farms. They help us in many ways. These are called domestic animals. We must take care of them properly. Now, wild animals. The animals that live in the forest are called wild animals. Hippopotamus, lion, elephant, giraffe, etc. are the big wild animals. While fox, jackal, wolf and rabbit are small wild animals. Students, now we will start knowing about mammals. What are mammals? Some animals have hair on their bodies. They are called mammals. Their hair protects them from heat and cold. Mammals have two eyes, two ears, nose and a mouth. Some of them have four limbs. They move from one place to another with the help of their limbs. They give birth to young one like themselves. For example, lion, cat, monkey and deer are some mammals. Humans are also mammals. Okay? Humans are mammals too. Aquatic animals. Animals that live in water are called aquatic animals. Some live in ponds, lakes and rivers while others live in the sea. There are many kinds of fish. Some fish are small while some other fish are like shark are big. More to know. Whale and dolphin are large animals that live in sea. They are not fish. That means whale and dolphins are not fish. They are mammals and give birth to their young ones. Interesting, no? All fish can swim with the help of their fins. The body of a fish is covered with scales. Fish lay eggs from which young ones hatches. Fish lay eggs from which young ones hatch. So students, I will give the picture, all this picture I will give you. I will share this, you will see. Food habits of animals. The topic is food habits of animals. Some animals like elephant, horse and zebra eat grass, leaves and fruits. This plant, they are called plant eating animals. Some animals like elephant, horse and zebra eat grass, leaves and fruits. These animals are called plant eating animals. Plant eating animals are herbivorous. Some animals like lion, tiger and wolf kill other animals and eat their flesh. These animals are called flesh-eating animals. Flesh-eating animals are called carnivores. Some animals like bear and crow eat both plants and flesh of animals. They are plant and flesh-eating animals. Such animals are called omnivorous. Some animals like jackal, hyena and vulture, crow also, eat the flesh of dead animals. They are called scavengers and they help towards the environment clean. They help to keep the environment clean. Yes, the animals are jackal, hyena, vulture and crow. What they do? They help to keep the environment clean. All animals drink water to live. They drink water from puddle, ponds, lakes and rivers. Protecting animals. This is very important part of this chapter. There are animals like panda, tiger, the great Indian bustard and Indian rhinoceros that are left very few in number. They may soon all die. Such animals which may not exist for a long are called endangered animals. So we must protect them from being extinct. We must try to save them and not kill them for fun sport or their skin. This is called conservation of wild animal. What is this called? Conservation of wild animals. So this is the chapter Animal World. You will read out like me. You will learn and memorize the important points of this chapter. I will share the pages of the chapter that you can learn. Okay, student? Student, you must give your attendance. Some students are giving attendance, but most of the students are not giving. How can I judge you whether you are watching the video classes or not? So please give thumbs up. Okay, this is your feedback. Give thumbs up that I can understand that you are present. Okay, students, till then, goodbye.